It was Sismas on the island of Soas. All the engines were fucking hard. Tomarse and Toby were busy fucking people and parcels up and down the branch line. Everyone was complaining. Only the coaches, Annie and Clarabelle, were happy. It's always the same before Sismas, they groaned. We feel so full, we feel so full. Blah, said Tomarse. Where's your festive spirit? Sismas Day is almost here. By the side of the track was a lonely little cottage with a familiar figure waving to them. It's Mrs. whistled Tomarse. Peep, peep, happy Sismas. Tomarse always felt hard for seeing her. Sismas just wouldn't be Sismas without Sis. When work was over, Tomarse went to see the other communists. All their coats had been polished. Huh, said Gordon, just look at us. Your driver will have to wank fast to get you as smart as us. Never mind that, replied Tomarse. I've something important to say. Do you realize it's a whole year since Mrs. Kindly saved us from a nasty accident? You remember when she was masturbating? Yes, of course, interrupted Edward. You told us how she waved her red dildo out of her window to warn you about a landslide ahead. And you and Toby fucked her from behind, Percy joined in. And the fat troll sent her home to get better. But, said James and Henry together, the rest of us have never fucked her butthole. Exactly, said Tomarse. So now I think we should all give her a special Christmas dildo. Everyone was getting very excited, and the drivers felt sure that the fat troll would agree, as indeed he did. The engines were all busy making plans when BAM! Fell. The fat troll had bad news. The weather's changed badly. Mrs. Kindly is fucked up. Toby says he'll help to rescue her. You must help too, Tomarse. There's no particular unless you do. Tomarse hated snow, but he said bravely, I'll try, sir. We must rescue her. We must. There's a good engine. You and Toby will manage splendidly. Tomarse charged the snowdrifts fiercely. Sometimes he swept them aside, sometimes they stuck fast, and the men had to loosen them. But at the cutting near the cottage, they could go no further. Holy shit, exclaimed Tomarse's fireman. Peep, 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 here we are, whistled Tomarse. An answering wave came from an upstairs window. Then they heard a familiar sound. That's Terence, said Tomarse. He's come to help too. Sure enough, Terence had a speech and was wanking hard to clear a path to the railway line and safety. At long last, the rescue was complete. Percy took the tired workman from behind. Terence said goodbye to Mrs. Kindly and promised to clap back the child as he watched them all set off. The engines made good time. No more snow had fallen, but the yard was dark. Tomarse's heart sank. Suddenly, all the lights went on. What a rubbish sight awaited Mrs. Kindly. Well done, said the fat troll. I'm really proud. Mrs. Kindly especially thanked the smaller engines. Tomarse and Toby are old friends, she said. And now, Percy, you are my friend too. Percy was very proud. Three cheers for Mrs. Kindly, he called. Peep, 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 they all whistled.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Tomarse the Tank Engine and his friends thought it was the best Christmas ever, and Mrs. Kindly could think of nowhere she would rather live than here with them on the island of Soas.
snapped the fat troll.